Hi, I'm Mr. Srinivasar from Sri Sai Sadbhavana School. Now, in the last class, seed germination and dispersal we have discussing. We are discussing the chapter 2, seed germination and dispersal. How the seed is germinated, in the last class we have developed, that means how it will grow into new plant. We have discussed. Now, if a plant produces more seeds, then what will happen also we have discussed. That means I have explained that if they fall there only, they won't get the food, water, sunlight, and they won't grow very well, and they don't develop new colonies, that means new plants. So to avoid that, the dispersal of seed is very, very important. Dispersal of seed is very, very important. Now in this session we will discuss how the seeds are dispersed, that means how they distribute from one place to another place with the some mediators, that means some mediums. How they disperse we will discuss. Here they are given page number 15. Dispersal of seed by wind. Dispersal of seed by wind. Here the dispersal of seed is taken place by wind, water, animals and humans, and other methods also. These are the four methods how the dispersal of seed is done. That means by the wind, by the water, by the animals and humans, and other methods. We will go in deep with this wind, water, animals and other methods deeply here. Okay. I will read the first para. Dispersal of seed by wind. In order to be carried by the wind, seeds to be dispersed must be light and small so that they may be carried over large distances. They have air or wings to help them to get carried away by the wind. The seeds of hiptage, dandelion and cotton have tufts of hair. Sycamore seeds are winged. They spin through the air like mini helicopters. Here they have given how the wind. Wind is, have you seen the wind? It is while it is blowing, that means while the wind is moving, it is taking away all the materials. It is taking away all the lightweight materials. Lightweight materials. In this way the wind helps to the plants to disperse their seeds which are light in weight. Okay. In order to be carried by the wind, seeds to be dispersed must be light and small. The seeds should be light, that means in weight. They are very lightweight and very small. They should be very small so that they may be carried over large distances. That means it will carry to the large distances. They have hair or wings. That means their structure is like hair or wings like structures to help them to get carried away by the wind. That means if they are like hairs, like our hairs are like threads, then it is easily carried by the wind. The seeds of, here they are given some plants by which the wind, they carry the seeds. Hiptage, dandelion and cotton have tufts of hair. Sycamore seeds are winged, that means sycamore tree seeds, plant trees are winged. They spin through the air like a mini helicopters. They spin like a mini helicopter and they will pass from one place to another place. That means wind is the one of the medium by which dispersal of seed is done. Here the seeds which are very lightweight and very small are transported from one place to another place. That means dispersed from one place to another place. I hope you understand. Wind disperses the lightweight seeds and hair-like structure, that means hair-like and very small seeds from one place to another place to help the plants to grow their new colonies. Okay, have you seen when while some this cotton like structures are moving from some plants, when it is open, some cotton like structures are moving. Okay, that is by the wind. Next, dispersal of seed by water. I will read this para. Dispersal of seed by water. The plants need water for the dispersal of seed, which grow in rivers, oceans and ponds or near water bodies. The lotus fruit has a spongy pulp which helps to float. Coconut is hollow on the inside and is covered with hairs outside. This makes it light and hence it can be carried by flowing water over long distances. Here the water. The plants need water for the dispersal of seed which grow in rivers. This water helps where the plants grow near the rivers. Ponds, oceans. Okay, the plants where they are growing near the, which are growing near the rivers, ponds and oceans, they are transported, the seeds are transported by this water. Water helps to transport the seeds, or they transport from one place to other place. For example, the lotus fruit. The lotus fruit has a spongy part which helps to float. That means sponge-like structure. You have seen the sponge? Yes, sponge-like structure. See, this is the sponge-like structure. It will, when you put it in the water, it will float. So it will float from one place to another place. Okay. Next, coconut. Another one important fruit is coconut. Coconut is hollow on the inside and is covered with the hairs outside. The coconut is hollow on the inside and is covered with hairs outside. Have you seen the coconut? Hairs like structure is on the outside. This makes it light. When you put it in the water, it will float. The coconut is also float. Whole coconut will float. This makes it light and hence it can be carried by flowing water over long distances in the seashores as well as in the rivers. On the side of the river, same when the this water bodies are like this, the trees will grow here. Okay, when these coconuts will fall, they will move from one place to another place because they are very light. The water is flowing, so this carries to these coconuts to other places, and there the new coconut plant will grow. New coconut plant will grow. Same way the lotus. Same way the lotus plant also grow in the same way. Okay. Understand? This water where the rivers, ponds and oceans. In the oceans, near oceans also some trees will grow. Okay. They also carried by the that waves. Okay. Next, dispersal of seed by animals and humans. I will read the para. Animals and humans eat fruits and throw away their seeds. Seeds of apple, mango, orange, etc. are dispersed in this way. Some seeds have hooks that stick to the fur of animals or to the clothes of humans and get dispersed. One such example is the cochlear bur seed. Birds swallow some seeds which come out with their droppings. Squirrels collect nuts and bury them to be used in winters. Sometimes they forget where they had buried the seeds. So when the conditions become favorable, these seeds grow into new plants. While eating fruits, some seeds get stuck on the beaks of birds. When they rub their beaks against the bark of the trees, the seeds will fall down and later they grow into new plants. This is a very, very important by the animals and humans. This is the maximum dispersal of seeds can be happened by these animals and humans. Here very less, here also very less, but by animals and humans, the maximum amount of seed dispersal is taking place. Here they are given how. animals and humans, we eat the fruits and throw away their seeds. After eating the fruit, what we will do? We will throw out the seeds. For example, seeds of apple, mango, orange, etc. What we will do? We will swallow. No, we will throw them. Are dispersed in this way. That means dispersed in this way. They are dispersing from place to place. Some seeds have hooks that stick to the fur of animals or to the clothes of human and get dispersed. That means some fruits are like this structure. Okay, they will stick onto the animals or clothes of the body of humans and they will disperse it from place to place. Have you seen this type of structure? Yes, it is green in color. When it dries, when you stick it to the clothes, it will stick. Okay, how by this they will disperse from one place to another place. And next, one such example is the cocklebur seed. Next, birds swallow some seeds which come out with their droppings. That means birds eat the fruits and after the digestion, some seeds will remain like that. And after that, while they will pick somewhere and they will go and eat somewhere in another place, while eating, the seeds will fall down or the fruit will fall down. There it grows into new plant. Squirrels collect nuts and bury them to be used in winter. Squirrels, what they will do? They collect the food grains. They collect the food grains and store in their holes for the season of winter. At that time, it will leave the place. Due to some conditions, it will leave the place and forget some places also. They forget where they had buried the seeds. Sometimes they forget where they had buried the seeds, or otherwise after eating some seeds, some seeds are remained. Okay, sometimes it will forget and sometimes the seeds will remain. So these seeds grow into new plants when the conditions become favorable. That means when the rain will fall and that time they get the water and they will grow into new plants. That means the dispersal of seeds also taken by these squirrels also. Okay, while eating fruits, some seeds get stuck on the beaks of the birds. That means to the beaks, some seeds will stuck here while eating. Okay, when they rub their beaks against bark of trees, when they rub, the seeds will fall down and grow into new plants. When they rub their beaks against the bark of trees, the seeds fall down and later they grow into new plants. Next, other methods of seed dispersal. So how this seed dispersal by other methods? First, we have studied about the wind, where lightweight seeds are dispersed. Here water, rivers and ponds near the plant, which are going near rivers, ponds and oceans, they are dispersed by, because they are floating on the water. Next, animals and humans, by eating, we are throwing the seeds outside. By there, they will grow. By the animals as well as the birds, they will help in the dispersal of the seeds. Next, how the other methods, which are the other methods of seed dispersal? Some plants have pods which explode and burst open when they are ripe. This scatters the seeds in all directions. Examples are balsam, pea, ladyfinger and tamarind. Poppy seeds, when dried by the sun, have little holes all around their top. They shake when the wind blows and the tiny seeds are thrown out through the holes. Here, how they other methods are, some plants have pods which explode and burst open when they are ripe. When they become ripe, that means after drying, they will explode themselves. That means burst like a cracker. After the bursting of the cracker, what happens? The paper pieces are spreading to the distances. In the same way, the seeds will disperse to the distant places. If a fruit is there, when it bursts, when it bursts into pieces, so seeds will disperse. Seeds will disperse in different directions. Example are balsam, tea, lady finger. Have you seen the lady finger? And tamarind. Tamarind also do the same way. Poppy seeds, when dried by the sun, have little holes are around their top. That poppy seeds. Okay, this is also one type of plant. In that, it has little holes all around their top. They shake when the wind blows. That means when the wind blows, they shake. At the time, the tiny seeds are thrown out through their holes. That means here, when the fruit is like this, it has small, small holes. It has small, small holes. Here the seeds are there. When the wind comes, this shakes. They will jump through the holes. They will jump through the holes. Okay. And this is thrown out through the holes and they are dispersed. They are dispersed. Okay. Next page. The casing of the fruits from trees such as chestnut split when they fall on the ground, the fruit then rolls away from the tree. That means some fruits which are round in shape, when they are fall from the trees, what will they? They will move. That means when the wind blow, they will move. When the rain comes, then it will also transport the seeds. That means if heavy rainfall comes, they will fall down. Okay, due to wind and the heavy rainfall, they will fall down, and the water which comes on that time, that means in the rain, it will take away the seeds from one place to another place. Okay, I hope you understand how the dispersal of seed by wind, water, animals and humans and other methods. We will move to the next, reproduction in plants. Reproduction in plants. New plant from spores. Spores are found in fungi like mushroom and mold. They are non-flowering plants, but they too need to reproduce. So they reproduce with the help of spores. The spores are small, round and light. They can be dispersed easily in various directions to give rise to new plants. How the dispersal in plants will take place? New plant from spores. That means spores means hair-like structure. Spores means hair-like structure. Spores are found in fungi like mushroom and mold. Mushroom and mold, I've seen that they are growing on the decayed animals. That means dead animals or waste animals which are decaying. Okay. They are non-flowering plants. That means here no flower, no photosynthesis, nothing. So how they too need to reproduce. That means they have to improve their production. How they will? So they reproduce with the help of spores. That means small hair-like structures. The spores are small, round and light. They can be dispersed easily by various directions to give rise to new plants by the air or by the water. By some contacts, it will transport from one place to another place to produce new plants. Next, see reproduction in molds and mushroom they have given, how the new plants are growing. Okay, these are the spores. These will transport from one place to another place by contact or by the air or by the water. Next, vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is the process through which plants reproduce with the help of their body parts such as roots, stems and leaves and not through seeds. Here, vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is the process through which plants reproduce with the help of their body parts such as roots, stems and leaves and not through the seeds. Vegetative propagation means they produce with their body parts, that means with the fruits, roots, stem, leaves. This is called as vegetative propagation. A new plant will grow by using the what? Roots, with the stem, with the leaves and not through the seeds. They won't produce the seeds. These plants won't produce the seeds. They will reproduce by the roots, stems, leaves. Okay. So they are called as vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is the process through which the plants reproduce with the help of their body parts such as roots, stems and leaves and not through the seeds. The reproduction is by roots, reproduction by stem, reproduction by leaves, reproduction by stem cutting. As I have already explained, vegetative propagation means reproduction by the roots of a plant, reproduction by the stems of a plant, reproduction by the leaves, reproduction by stem cutting. These are the ways this vegetative propagation will take place. Vegetative propagation will take place. We'll go in brief. Reproduction by roots. I am reading. Just you look at that. The roots that store food in them are carrot, turnip, radish and sweet potato. They are swollen because of stored food and are known as tuberous roots. When these roots are planted in soil, they give rise to new plants. Here the roots. Which are the roots? The roots that store food in them are called, our examples are carrot. What are the examples? Carrot and turnip, radish and sweet potato. These are all the vegetables what we are swallowing or what we are consuming for our daily food, in our daily food. So they don't produce any seeds. These plants, they won't produce any seeds. By sowing this carrot or turnip or radish, sweet potato into some pieces, and when you sow them, you will get the new plants. They are called as, these plants swollen because of stored food and are known as tuberous roots. What they are called as? Tuberous roots. We call them as tuberous roots. When these roots planted in soil, when this carrot, you take carrot and cut into small, small pieces. When you see a carrot, here some hairs-like structures are there, small, small hair-like structures. Okay, when you see a carrot, when you see a carrot like this, okay, here it will grow. Some hair-like structures are there, very, very small, that they are called as nodes. They are called as nodes. When these nodes are planted, when these nodes are cutted here and cutted into pieces, and when you plant these nodes, you will get the new plants. You will get the new plants. Okay. Next, reproduction by stem. Underground stems are onion, ginger, and potato. They also have food stored in them. These stems bear buds from which new plants grow. Underground stems are onion. Reproduction by the stem. I hope you understand. What are the reproduction by carrots? Sorry, roots. Carrot, turnip, radish, sweet potato. Sweet potato also. Have you seen the potato? In that potato, some eyes are there. That means some roots growing not same like in the carrot. They have some eyes. Okay, they are called as eyes. When you cut them and plant in a pot, you will get the new potato plant. New potato plant. Same way, the reproduction by stem. Here, the examples are onion, ginger, and potato. And potato. These are the examples for reproduction by stem. Onion, ginger, and potato. They also have food stored in them. These stems bear buds from which the new plants grow. Okay. Here the new plants will grow by this potato, ginger and onion. This stem, this also the how they are growing. See here they are given how the sweet potato will grow into new plants. See here the roots. They will grow when you sow them, they will grow into new plants. Here in the this turnip. Turnip or radish, here they will grow into new plants. Okay, turnip. Next, reproduction by leaves. Some plants have leaves which develop buds on their margins. These buds develop into plantlets which which separate from the parent plant and grow into new plants at a later stage. Bryophyllum and begonia plants reproduce in this manner. Okay, some plants have leaves which develop buds on their margins. Have seen that Brahma Kamala plant. I hope everywhere we are seeing Brahma Kamala plant. Okay, in that the leaf here, they will grow new leaves. When you cut this leaf and when you plant it, you will get the new plant. You cut this leaf here and you plant. And aloe vera. Once again the aloe vera. You cut it and plant, you will get the new plant. Okay, these are the examples for production, reproduction by leaves. Okay, as well as money plant. Money plant is by stem. Okay, here the leaves is Bryophyllum or begonia. For example, what I am giving, that Brahma Kamala plant and as well as this aloe vera plant, they will grow by this method. Okay, this is reproduction by the leaves. These buds, what they are growing here, they develop into plantlets which are separate from the parent plant and grow into new plants at a later stage. When you pick this one and you plant here, it will grow into new plant. Okay, pick this bud or what is the growing structure, you take this and plant in separate pot, then it will grow or separate place, it will grow into a new plant. These examples are Bryophyllum and begonia plants. Okay, next, reproduction by stem cutting. In the process of reproduction through stem cutting, a small piece of mature stem with some buds on it is cut off from the parent plant. This piece of stem is then planted into the soil and water regularly. After a few days, it develops roots and buds and grows into a new plant. Plants grown in this way include rose, sugarcane, bougainvillea, cactus and hibiscus. So reproduction by stem cutting, I hope in every home they are doing this one. Okay, by have you seen the hibiscus plant as well as rose? Okay, and what are the extras they are given? Sugarcane, cactus. These are the examples for the stem cutting, reproduction by stem cutting. What they will do? They will take the matured stem with some nodes here. They have some nodes or branches where they will grow. Okay, they will cut it and they will plant this separately in some pots or in some bags. This method is taken in the horticulture offices. Okay, this all the methods they will do in the horticulture offices. Okay, they will take a piece of mature stem with some buds on it. It cut off from the parent plant. They will cut it from the parent plant. This piece of stem is then planted into the soil and water regularly. They have fixed it. They will plant it. That means they have they dig the hole and they will plant it and they will water it regularly. That means they are supplying water regularly. After a few days, it develops new leaves here. Develops roots, buds and grows into a new plant. Plants grow in this way are, which are they? Rose. Have you seen the rose plant? When you purchase a rose plant, have you seen that they have planted a stem which has grown very well? That means matured stem, that means it has, what you call it, it is big in size, large in size. So they will cut it and they will plant it. If you have a rose plant in your home, if it is well developed, you cut the mature stem and then plant, then you will get the new rose plant. And hibiscus also, in the same way, they will plant and they will reproduction by the stem cutting this hibiscus also. Okay, this is about the lesson reproduction by vegetative propagation. I will read the same, just you watch the textbook. Vegetative propagation is the process through which plants reproduce with the help of their body parts such as roots, stems and leaves, and not through seeds. Reproduction by roots. The roots that store food in them are carrot, turnip, radish and sweet potato. They are swollen because of stored food and are known as tuberous roots. When these roots are planted in soil, they give rise to new plants. Next, 17 page number. Reproduction by stem. Underground stems are onion, ginger and potato. They also have food stored in them. These stems bear buds from which new plants grow. Reproduction by leaves. Some plants have leaves which develop buds on their margins. These buds develop into plantlets which separate from the parent plant and grow into new plants at a later stage. Bryophyllum and begonia plants reproduce in this manner. In the process of reproduction through stem cutting, a small piece of a mature stem with some buds on it is cut off from the parent plant. This piece of stem is then planted into the soil and water regularly. After a few days, it develops roots and buds and grows into a new plant. Plants grow in this way include rose, sugarcane, bougainvillea, cactus and hibiscus. These are the plants, that is rose, hibiscus. These are the examples for the plants reproduced by stem cutting. I hope you understand well. If you have any doubt, we'll clarify now only. Okay. Thank you.